Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. In this video, you'll learn how to align your measuring data to the CAD and how to create a few simple inspections using the functions in the main toolbar. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. Let's get started. I'll open a project that contains nominal and actual data, in other words, a CAD and a polygonized mesh. If you want to know how to import data and what data formats are supported, have a look at the video How to Import Data with ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. If you look at the data in this project, you'll see that the CAD and actual mesh don't align. That's because they are aligned in their respective coordinate systems and were imported as such. When you look at the status of your project, you'll see that part of the status bar is red. Click it to open the project guide. The tab Project Guide helps you with your inspections by providing hints and possible actions. As you can see here, you need to create an alignment in order to compare the actual data to the nominal data. All you need to do now is click Create Alignment. You can have more than one alignment in your project, but you usually start with an initial alignment to bring the two datasets together. And that's exactly what the software suggests. So let's create a pre-alignment. In this case, we'll create a pre-alignment between the parts CAD and actual mesh. For more information about the pre-alignment and its parameters, look at the tech guide. Now, let's compare the CAD to the actual mesh. ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D can display the deviations of the actual data to the nominal over all coordinates. To do that, use surface comparison on CAD. You can adjust the legend by clicking the upper or lower limit. Link the two limits to scale the legend symmetrically for positive and negative deviations. Red indicates that the material lies above the CAD surface. Blue means that the material lies below the CAD surface. You can also obtain discrete values for these deviations by using deviation labels. Open Point Inspection in the main toolbar and select Deviation Labels. To get a preview, press Ctrl and move the cursor over an area. To create the deviation label, press Ctrl and the left mouse button. For more information about the mouse commands associated with a function, have a look at the tooltip down here. To exit the function, click the right mouse button or press Escape. You can also display a go/no-go representation of the surface comparison. To do that, right-click the legend and under Legend Type, select Tolerance Legend. This representation shows if the deviations are inside or outside of a given tolerance. You can edit the tolerance for the surface comparison in the Properties window. Alternatively, you can set tolerances for individual patches on your CAD by using Edit Patches. You can use the search to open the function or use Operations, CAD, Edit Patches. Display the CAD exclusively. You can simply drag and drop it into the 3D view or select it and use the keyboard shortcut E. Select patches by pressing Ctrl and the left mouse button. You can select multiple patches. Then define the tolerances. You can also use the mouse wheel to do that. Click Apply and then close the function. Now display the surface comparison again and open the properties. In the tab Tolerances, under Tolerance Source, select From CAD. Okay, so far so good. Now let's investigate the local deviations on the letter Z here. This letter is a removable component, and I suspect that it was mounted incorrectly. To determine if the deviations are due to an incorrect mounting position or represent local defects on the Z, I'll create a local best fit alignment. As I mentioned before, you can have more than one alignment in your project. Currently, we have a pre-alignment which included a global best fit. The local best fit will be constrained to the area we want to investigate. Here's how it works. Click the plus in the main toolbar to create a new alignment. Select Local Best Fit. Both the warning in the creation dialog and the tooltip tell you what you need to do next. Select an area on the actual data. Display the mesh exclusively in the 3D view. In the toolbar, click Select Deselect Through Surface. Use the left mouse button to select the area around the letter Z. Click the right mouse button to complete the selection. Adjust the view of the part in the 3D view to refine your selection. Then, use Select Deselect Through Surface again to deselect the area on the base plate. Click and hold the right mouse button to mouse over to deselect. Then click OK to create the local best fit. With the local best fit active, let's look at the surface comparison again. The deviations on the letter Z have almost disappeared and instead re-emerged on the base plate. That means that the Z was positioned incorrectly and that the deviations were not caused by a form error. This is a typical application for a local best fit. Note that you can switch back and forth between the alignments in your project and the software updates the results automatically. Let's move on to another inspection. In addition to the surface comparison, you can create a full field comparison for sections. To do that, use the function Inspection Section in the main toolbar. We'll create an inspection section on CAD. Choose a reference plane and create a section at any position parallel to it. You can use the mouse wheel to adjust the plane's position. When you click Create and Close, the software automatically creates the three elements you need for the inspection section: a nominal section, an actual section, and a curve. To display the inspection section exclusively, drag and drop it into the 3D view. If you want to obtain discrete values, you can place deviation labels on the section. In this case, let's use the function Equidistant Deviation Labels. It allows you to create deviation labels at a certain point distance along the entire curve. Now, if you need to make changes, say you made a mistake or the requirements changed, you can simply edit the creation parameters of any element in ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. Just right-click the element and select Edit Creation Parameters, or select the element and use the keyboard shortcut F4. To show you, I'll change the position of the inspection section. As you can see, the position of the deviation labels changed based on the new position of the section. That's one of the best things of ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. It keeps track of all the dependent elements and adjusts their parameters automatically. Please note that the parametric inspection, which is the concept behind this functionality, is only available with a Pro license. Now, let's talk about visualizing hidden areas and inspections. To inspect small or hidden areas on your part more closely, you can use the extensive clipping functionalities. You can use clipping at plane, for example, or you can use the clipping block to customize your clipping view. You can edit all the planes of the clipping block. And you can move the object in the pip. The pip shows an overview of the area you're looking at, while the 3D view shows the clipped measuring object. When you're finished, you can disable clipping here. We've now created a few inspection results within the project. You can document these results at any time by creating a report page. To do that, click Create Report Page in the main toolbar. Select the style of your report page and name it. To adjust the position of the content in the 3D view, click Edit Content. Once you created a report page, you can find it in the Explorer. To work with your report pages, you can either switch to the report workspace or open the tab Report Page and place it anywhere. For more information about reporting, like the workspace and presentation mode, check out the video Reporting with ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. So much for simple inspections. Now, of course, ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D has much more to offer still. If you're curious, take a look at the tutorial How to perform GD&T inspections in ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. And if you're looking for more comprehensive training, check out the INSPECT Optical 3D Basic e-learning. You'll find the link in the description below.